Want to know how to make Pinterest board covers? Looking for an easy to follow tutorial on designing Pinterest board covers in Canva? If so, this is the video for you. Hey y'all, it's Natalie Vardo, your Pinterest coach here, and be sure to click that thumbs up button if you love Pinterest training, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel because I've got free weekly Pinterest videos coming your way. So let's talk about those Pinterest board covers. They can look like this. They're square images that appear on the saved tab of your profile. So if you're scrolling, it could look something like this. It's a highlight image, which takes up the most of the preview of whatever are the images, which are the pins that are saved to your profile. So you might want to customize or set a board cover if you want to polish up or take your Pinterest account to the next level. Maybe you want to get serious about Pinterest and you want to make a statement. And it's important to, of course, be on brand. That's key when it comes to designing board covers. So let's get started with a few examples to get you inspired. And then we're going to hop right into Canva and I'll show you how easy it is for you to design on brand Pinterest board covers. We'll cover things like size and some design tips. So let's look at some examples right on Pinterest. I pulled a few profiles you're going to love. So Sasha here, every day she's sparkling. We can see that her board covers are in this hot pink with the light border there on brand. So all of these are her board covers. We can also see right here that Elise, she just updated some of her board covers and we can see them right here in this salmon and this taupe type color scheme. So they're square images and they're going to be on brand. So you can see right here, they look a lot like her Pinterest pins. So get inspired, think of how you can design your own board covers that match your Pinterest pins or your branding overall. Right here, the sparkling brunette also has some very cute board covers. We can see they have a border. So all of these are her board covers. So you might be wondering, why are some of these board covers not on brand? That's because she belongs to group board. So whoever is the creator of that specific Pinterest board is the one that sets the board cover. So we can see here, these are all different because they're not her boards. Here's another example that I love by Amanda at The Rising CEO. We can see how they have this color wash, tie-dye feel. Super gorgeous. So your board covers can all have the same color or they can be a variety of different colors in your palette like that one, or even like this Gen Y girls covers. We can see she has some that are yellow, red, or green. They're on brand for her, but they're slightly different. It's the same design, but different colors. And lastly, you can also put your branding specifically in terms of your domain name right on your pin covers, like Marina of Yes to Tech does here. All of her pin board covers say Yes to Tech. So you can add your logo or even just your domain name to make it branded to your profile. And in our last example, we're looking at Carly from 52 Cities blog. This is who we're going to design a board cover for. You can see that some of her board have covers, but some don't. So how about we hop right in Canva and I'll show you how you can design your first board cover. Let's get started. So here we are right in Canva. If you haven't created a Canva account before, click the link down below to start your free account. You can also claim a free pro trial, which is going to give you access to some more features, like being able to upload your custom font for your brand if you have one. So I'm going to go ahead and click on create a design. And you're going to want to create a custom size. So for our Pinterest board covers, we're going to create it at 1000 by 1000 pixels. That's going to be big enough, high resolution, and it's going to work for us. So then click create new design. And here we have our square canvas. And this is where you're going to add in your text and some brand elements. So what board are you creating this for? So over on Carly's profile, for example, we're going to create one for Europe Road Trip. That's the name of the board. It doesn't have a cover as yet. So let's do one for that. So first thing is you're going to want to drop in the text. So I'm going to click on text and I'm just going to add one here. I'm going to change it to her brand font and I'm going to do Europe. I'm going to do Europe in the big font. I'm going to move it to where I want it, drag it to make it larger. And then I'm going to add a secondary font and this is going to say road trip. So go ahead and make your font nice and big so that it's going to be visible. So I'm going to select her second brand font. So Carly's fonts are in caps. So I'm just going to click right here and that's that. So we have the text. So your next option when designing your board covers is deciding whether you're going to add background images or background color, maybe a border. What are the design elements that match your branding? So you might take a look at your Pinterest pins and decide, okay, maybe I'll have a background photo, maybe I'll do a border, maybe there'll be a line. So let's add in those brand elements. So with Carly's, we're just gonna add in a background image. And you can do that either by uploading your own photos that you've taken, or you can take a look by clicking on more and photos to access all of their stock photos. So I'm actually just gonna look for road trip as an image, someone driving in a car, or maybe this open road. I'm gonna drop it into the background, but we can see this doesn't look anything like her board covers, right? So we're gonna change the color a bit. You can also click right here where it says transparency. You can lighten the photo if that works for you. What you can also do is click on elements and I'm just gonna add a shape. I'm going to click on this shape and just cover the entire image. I'm gonna change the color to a gray. Then I'm gonna go back to transparency and lighten it a bit. So Carly's, they have white font. So I'm just gonna change this to white. I'm gonna darken this a little bit more. It's not quite right. So I can just change the color by always just clicking on the element. Then right up here, I'll make it darker. It's more of a green. We can play around with colors here. That's better. Okay. And her boards have a line. So I'm just gonna create a line. It's right here in elements. I'm gonna change this to her brand colors right here. I can change the shape of it. And that's that. So we can see we've created a board cover that is very much on brand with her other board covers. So you can do something similar. Maybe you want to add a border. So to do that, you're going to click on elements. And we can see down here, we have lines and shapes. You have all these options for design elements you can add. There are different types of borders. You just click and you're gonna drag it to the edge if you wanna add a border. And of course, to change the color, you would just change it here, but make sure that color is on brand, okay? So once you're happy with your new board cover, you can easily download it. You're gonna click download in the top right. Select PNG and then just click download. So it's downloading your new board cover and then you're ready to upload it to Pinterest. So with your brand new board cover designed and downloaded, let's head right over to Pinterest and I'll show you exactly how to upload it or how to change your board cover. So here I am on Carly's profile and we'll see on the save tab, we've got all of those Pinterest boards. So go ahead and find the board that you want to change the cover for. You're then gonna click on the plus sign and you're gonna click on pin and you're gonna upload that image you just designed. So to change your board cover, you first have to save that new image as a pin on Pinterest to the board you want that to be the cover of. So if that's confusing, I'll show you. I'm gonna create a pin with that brand new image. I'm gonna call it Europe Road Trip. That same board is selected. So for the description of this pin, I would just add in your board description. So just copy whatever description you set for your board. If you need help with writing descriptions, check out this video on Pinterest SEO and how to find your keywords. In terms of where you're going to link to, do not link to your Pinterest board. Instead, link to content on your site. So I'm going to look up this blog post. And right here, 5 tips for road trip. I'm going to copy the link to this. And then back in Pinterest, I'm going to paste this as the destination link. For alt text, you're just describing the image. So I'm going to say with, the open road. Okay. So here we have it. I'm going to click publish. It's publishing your board cover to this board where you want it to be the cover of. And it's created a pin. So click on see your pin. So right now this is our board cover and it's pinned to this Europe road trip. Click on that board. And what I want you to do is click on the triple dots and click on edit board. So you're gonna click right here where it says edit board cover. The first image is the newest one we just uploaded. So click on it, move or scale. We don't need to because it's perfectly square, and then click done. And then click done again. And there we have it. This is our board cover. So if you go back to your profile and we take a look right at that Europe board, we can see right here, there's our brand new board cover. So that's exactly how you can create on-brand board covers for your Pinterest profile in Canva for free. So get started, customize your profile, make it look as professional as possible. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. And of course, subscribe to my channel because I love being your Pinterest coach. And speaking of Pinterest coaching, stick around. You're gonna find this video helpful. Bye for now.